Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. Artcast number, I think it's 59. How's everybody doing? It's going to be a semi-short one because I actually have to upload this thing today, so I'm going to watch the clock on it. So I got like 15 minutes, I suppose. So if I do like a 40-minute one, then it'll take like, you know, 4 hours to upload, and just won't be up today. But I want to get first one of the week up for on time, for crying out loud. That's just no good. I missed that one. But working on this piece here, just another fantasy piece. I thought I was all ready to finish up the Hercules one and get going on commission that I need to do, and I don't know, I just started this one over the weekend and just thought let's do this first and then I'll get going on my usual stuff again. But kind of like how these fantasy ones are just coming out, you know. I'm not sure if this one's gonna work or not. This one's probably gonna look a lot different when I finally get it finished and up on the site. But yeah, I don't know. I've been painting them in a little different technique. Somebody asked me, like, what's the difference between this stuff and my usual work, because I was kind of talking about it being different. And one thing is that there's not as much of the photo reference I've been being able to follow, but the main difference is I'm actually painting, doing like a painting like you can see here with a brush and then drawing on it, rather than kind of, and eventually I'll show you guys more what I'm talking about, but there's not really much of an underdrawing. I just kind of started into paint, and this is sort of where I got. And then at some point when I kind of feel like I'm as far as I can go with the paint, I get the color pencils out and then do a separate step. And then I've been bringing in airbrush in at the very end and kind of making the parts I want softer and that kind of stuff. So it's a different kind of technique and a little bit more immediate one. And I don't know, I've been liking it. I've been painting, like when I paint, it's a little bit more of like a build up, like with just kind of like more like washes, I guess, and then getting to the point where I can get opaque with it. And I've just been kind of liking it. And I've also just, I've been digging on the subject matter a little bit, you know. I guess it started with the with that Dark Wolf Frazetta thing I did, and kind of like, and then when it sold, it kind of gave me a little more confidence to, I think, do another one. And then I did the Pegasus one, which just sold today, and, you know. Here's the Pegasus one. Should probably get packaged up and sent out tomorrow. I wanted to thank whoever bought it very much, because I don't know. It's just, it sucks when you're doing something that you don't have much confidence in, and then it doesn't sell, or, you know, which I know putting it on eBay isn't exactly a good gauge of that, but, you know, where I kind of need money, it's like the only gauge I kind of got. But and then my color pencil work is a lot more kind of rough and linear through these things too. Like, it's tough to see it, but like on his back and his helmet, and I wish I could show it a little better. Maybe I'll take some pictures and post it on my blog. But I don't know, I just like this piece. It was like a piece that kind of kicked my butt for a while, and, you know, I finally feel like I conquered it and got it done. And I want to make a print and put it on eBay also, and put it on my store, and just see how well that does. And it's cool. I don't know, you get in that mode where you start to buy into this kind of idea that, like, people are just buying your stuff just because it's Star Wars, or just because it's this. And it's just nice, because I went completely to left field on this and people still were interested, so makes me feel good. Then here's the Dark Wolf piece. Haven't sent this one either. He bought that right around Friday, so I don't usually send stuff over the weekend. because you can't send stuff first class over the weekend. You can only send priority. And so it's sitting here. It'll go out today. But I almost hate to see it go. I really do like this one. And I almost feel it's like a little bit of a kind of breakthrough with my art in a way. Kind of opened my mind up to a little bit different technique. So pretty cool. Anyway, thanks for whoever bought that one too. And also thanks for the guy who bought the first drawing. I really wasn't planning on painting this piece. It just kind of like was one of those kind of spur of the moment kind of things. Usually when I paint a piece, I'll hold back on putting the drawing up till afterwards, but just the way it worked out. But at any rate, as you can see, like, the paintings are a lot more, it's like the color pencil really helps my painting, at least with acrylic. I've always felt like I can't paint very well with acrylics, and the drawings just help it out. But I wanted to mention too, last night I was on the Artcasters. I'm going to try to embed actually the show into my site on whenever this one goes up. It was, I think, the fourth one we've done, the Artcasters chat show, which is connected to the Artcasters Facebook group. And if you're an artist on YouTube or anywhere else and, you know, want to join a cool Facebook group that, you know, where you can post your stuff and promote and get traffic to your site and your videos and all that kind of stuff, you should come join, because it's really cool, it's fun, and there's just a ton of people in there doing all kinds of stuff, all kinds of art. There's some fine art type people, some fantasy type people, there's like the fan art type stuff, there's everything, and we're all getting along, which is really cool. You know, it's not like all this some of these other sites where people have attitude and stuff. So it's just a fun, like, supportive group. And also, if you're selling stuff, come promote your stuff there, because that's part of it too. I wanted to make it so that everybody could benefit, and you know, so nobody has any problem with posting like eBay links and stuff in there. As long as you're not posting eBay links to like golf clubs or something, I'm cool with it. But anyway, the chat, the Artcasters chat show was, maybe I should just put the camera on me, because I'm not exactly painting right now, but, okay, there you go. I'll just put the camera on me a bit, because I don't know if I'll be painting much on that thing right at the moment, since I got to keep this video kind of short, and maybe I'll kind of stay more on topic. Yesterday, though, sorry, I'm looking at the camera now. Thinking I should have combed my hair this morning. But anyway, we did the Artcasters chat over the weekend, which was a lot of fun. There was some, let's see, who all was in there? Scott Circland, is that his name, Circland? Yeah, and I think his website is called Circworks. If you go to the show, there's links to everybody in there. Maybe I'll try to hunt up the links for and put them in my video. He was there. Peter Palmiotti, who hosted it, was there, obviously, and I really appreciate him doing that. Peter also has a Patreon page, and if you're into like all this stuff that he does for Artcasters, and also on his own site, he does another show called Studio Synergy, which is a bunch of artists drawing. You should go and support him on Patreon, because I know the guy needs it. Who else was in there? Oh, Sid Longines, I hope I got his name right, finally. Really awesome airbrush artist, does, you know, incredible work on paper and everything else, leather jackets, all that kind of stuff. He came by. There was a new guy, Johannes, I think his name was, and his nickname's Nessie. And I remember asking him about his website, and I'm not quite sure if he gave me an answer or not. It sounded almost like he was getting one up. Which, that's something I should talk about eventually, actually. It just kind of popped in my mind. That's a good topic for a show, is how do you get a website up when you're just getting started out. That's what it sounded like with him. It was like he's just kind of getting started with selling art and getting started online and stuff. He said something like, like he just got his first computer a little while ago, like a year ago or something. I might be wrong there, but I think that's what he said. But yeah, he was a real cool guy, looking forward to seeing some of his stuff. He said he's going to start posting in the Artcasters and all that, so that would be very cool. But it was a great conversation, at any rate. Seems like there was somebody else there. Okay, actually I just checked, and that was everybody that was in there. Sometimes it's a blur, because we did it pretty late at night, and we had me and my wife and son went to my mom's house for dinner and everything, so that was like a whole ordeal, and then finally, you know, at 10 o'clock we do the show, but it's a lot of fun. I thought there was something else I was going to talk about a little bit, but I guess not. And I do want to keep this one short, so maybe I should wrap it up. But that's a long podcast. If you're Dyke Jones and to listen to something, you could click that on and listen to what we had to say. And honestly, last night was a pretty good show where we talked some about promotion and that kind of stuff. And that's something I don't talk about so much on this show. So that was good. We talked some about eBay and also a little bit about the copyright thing, which that was kind of interesting to kind of get in there and hear everybody's thoughts and just, you know, I think everybody doesn't like talking about it because it's, I don't know, and just one thing we talked about was just kind of how, you know, there's no real like right and wrong answer in a way, not a real right and a wrong answer, that's probably not what I meant, but just, how it's hard to kind of know what the line is, I guess. But I don't want to get into all that here. But if you want to check out the show, it's cool. As long as I'm talking here, the thing about like putting up a new website and stuff, I thought it just because it's on my mind suddenly. When I first got on the web, because I didn't get on that early. I think I got on the web around 2004 or 2005 or something, pretty late compared to a lot of guys, and didn't know anything, and I got on because my wife had a computer and she showed me the internet finally, and then I was like, hey, there's people posting art on here, you know, so like, of course I want to put my art on there. And I was gonna say though is like, my wife, you know, had went to art school and stuff, and she always was like, oh, I'm gonna make you a website, and of course she never did it. And when I first got on, I was just like, well, I'm going to figure out how to do it myself. But like, the whole making a website, especially back then, seemed just daunting. And there was like different pay sites that were willing to take your money and all that. But of course, like always, I had no money or didn't want to pay anybody. So I just always found the workaround. And like, when I first just started out, I found... like, even back then, there was free blogger sites, and I think the first one I got on was, it was called Zanga or something like that. I think that site's completely gone now, but I just treated it almost like my website now, where I just posted my art and figured out a way to kind of link from the blog to, like, old blog posts, so that, like, an old blog post could be, like, the gallery page, you know? And then later, I found, not that much later, I mean just like a month later or something, I found DeviantArt, and I posted my stuff there. And that's pretty much a website, you know what I mean? It's like, maybe it's not super pro, but I don't know that anything is super pro anymore, really, you know? I kind of find like the super pro slick websites kind of annoying, and I notice like most of the people I follow, I so rarely go to their website. I'll go to their blog a lot or their Facebook page and things like that, but I don't really even bother with the website, which probably took a ton more work than they put into their blog. And that's because there's not much new content, and a lot of times it's hard to get new content onto your website. It's a lot more of a pain in the neck than it is just to push a button and post a blog post. So a lot of times people's websites get neglected and stuff like that. But I thought I'd just put that out there, because I know there's a few people that they don't have websites, you know, and a few guys that have been on the Artcasters where they're like, I don't have a website, I have a Facebook page. And I think that's actually fine. The thing about Facebook is, I think it's a little bit harder to showcase your work, because somebody's got to go to your Facebook page, then they got to go and look at your photos. for it to be like, there's my portfolio or something. So, but the thing is like you can use like almost anything for your website or your web presence. That's more what it should even be, is just like web presence. And an easy way to kind of have like sort of the pseudo website is to just go on to a place called GoDaddy or another place that sells domain names. And I use GoDaddy. I don't know if they're the best. I kind of like get really super annoyed by them, but you know, that's the one that I figured out to use. And you just go on there and you type in what you want, like whatever your thing is, like jefflafferty.com, for example. And it'll either be available or not. And then you buy it. I don't know what mine costs, probably like $15 or so for like a year or 2 years. And then once you bought it, you go into the settings on your domain name. You get into GoDaddy, go into your settings, and then somewhere in there, there's going to be a button that says redirect or something like that. And then it'll give you the option to redirect that domain name to your website or your Facebook page or wherever you want it to go. So if you have a DeviantArt page, you can have jefflafferty.com, and then it just shoots people to your DeviantArt page, and then it's like right there you got a website. And I've also seen, like, which I think is a super clever idea, is guys doing their website as a store envy store. And so like the front page of their website is the store envy store, which store envy is a place where you can set up a store and it doesn't cost anything. And I think there's add-ons where you can have it be like, you know, have more stuff to, you know what I mean, more I don't know, bells and whistles on your store to for whatever reason, I don't know. What am I saying? Like, anyway, the store envy is like a great site to set up a store on. That's where my store is. I've had stores on eCreator and different places, and I really like store envy. I think it's the best store I've had so far. And what's also really, really, really awesome about it is if you know any HTML, you can go in there and tweak things and make it look exactly like your website. So I haven't quite got mine looking exactly like my website, but I think I've almost kind of come to the conclusion that I kind of want to make my website a little bit more like my store envy site because it looks a little better, but it's pretty close right now. And I've seen guys basically, you know, they buy the domain name, they shoot people straight to the front page of their store, and then in the store envy toolbar or whatever, they have you know, they have all their products, and then they just put in their links to their site. So they kind of meld their site, whatever it is, with their store. And you could even do that with like a DeviantArt page. So it's like you put in a link to like a blog or news feed or something like that, and then it would kick people out of your store envy store into your, you know, to your site, whatever that is, a blogger site or whatever, and then have links pushing back the other way to your store. So it just becomes like one kind of cohesive thing. And it's a super easy way just to set up a website without going like, okay, I need a, you know, even though it's gotten so much easier with WordPress and things like that. But to me, like, I don't know, if you need one like tomorrow, which, you know, if you're selling stuff, yeah, you probably do, because, you know, it's like once somebody buys something, they might want to buy a print, they might want to find out about you. And it's like, you might as well give them more of an option than just Facebook, because Facebook, you know, the thing is, like, somebody goes and follows you on Facebook, you know, Facebook clamps down on what they let your followers see, you know. So, like, every post you do on Facebook doesn't go out to your entire list of people that follow you. It only goes out to a small percentage. So that kind of sucks. But if you're on your website, if you have a website somewhere or some kind of website or a blogger site or even like a store envy store with a button that goes to like a newsletter sign up or something like that. And all this stuff is like super easy to do, you know. But those guys that go and follow you there or like check your stuff out at your blog or whatever, then you have access to them. If they sign up for a newsletter, you can send out your newsletter, or like, you know, like my newsletter is pretty much just like I just send out updates of whenever I put up a video or put up a post, and then my blog acts like a newsletter. So
whatever I'm doing is on my blog or in my videos. And if you sign up for my newsletter, which everybody should, then that's what you get. You basically get an email whenever I update the site, which is one every day, but I update every day, so I don't know. Maybe that's too much. Anyway, that's, I don't know if everybody followed me there. It's kind of just, you know, to the specific group of people out there that are kind of like, maybe kind of like looking at the whole thing going, I need a website, I need this, and it's so much to learn, and I gotta buy domain hosting, and I gotta spend money, and all that kind of stuff. It's really not true. At one time, I did make a site where I did have that. I had my own domain hosting, and I had to pay, and all that kind of stuff, and it was a big pain in the neck. And my site now is a blogger site, and it's just one that I've kind of cobbled together. It's two blogger sites, actually. One blogger site is the gallery, and the other blogger site is my blog, you know. And that one is just a normal blog. The gallery one is just one that I've kind of just stripped everything out of, took out all the buttons, and then like put my own links in so that you can click over to the gallery and click back. That's one of the reasons my stats are kind of screwed up sometimes when people try to advertise on my site, because they're not seeing the clicks for my whole site, because it's actually two sites. But anyway, there's a lot of, you know, free ways to do it, and super free ways to do it that you could just get your stuff up today, and it would help you with, you know, the whole thing, you know, help you with the selling or whatever the heck you're trying to do. So anyway, yeah, that was probably a good show. I'm going to actually stick this in Sony Vegas and render it and put it up on YouTube. And yeah, everybody have a good day. And I'll see you tomorrow.